Anatomy of the brain. The brain is made up of more than 100 billion specialized type of cell that is referred to as neurons and supporting cell that are referred to as neuroglia. The supporting cells help to give structural support to the neurons, and they also help to provide support for the activities that the neurons exhibit, such as the formation of synapses and so on. They will need to be supplied with blood, so you have the capillary network also embedded within the brain tissue. The weight of the brain is about 1.5 kilograms. It is the most complex and delicate organ in the body. It is most complex in the sense that it's a connection of neurons connected from one end to the other in a form of circuit, and this circuit cannot be distorted, hence the functions that they exhibit will be impaired. They are also delicate, and that is why the brain tissue is enclosed or accommodated within the bony neurocranium, which helps to protect it from injury or damage. Different regions of the brain are designed to exhibit different functions. The first set that I would look into is the memory. Within the cerebrum, we have functional areas that are responsible for memory. We also have regions within the cerebrum hemisphere that are responsible for sensory perception. For the sensation of touch, temperature, proprioception, and other sensory activities, and motor sensation, which is responsible for the ability for the movement of voluntary muscle. We also have regions that are responsible for speech production. The other functions could include the visual perception in the occipital region of the cerebrum hemisphere. We also have the function of breathing, arousal and consciousness, heart rate, and also the sleep and wake cycle is also being controlled by the brain. Hearing, which is auditory, the ability for us to hear what people say. We also have the perception of taste as a function of the brain. Virtually all the activities that the body undergo are being controlled by the brain. We have subdivisions. The brain can be subdivided into three subregions. We have the forebrain that is also referred to as the prosencephalon, and this is the forebrain. We have the midbrain, which is also referred to as the mesencephalon. This is the midbrain. Then we have the hindbrain that is also called the robencephalon, and this is the robencephalon. This is the primary brain vesicle, and this is where the brain developed from. So they have three subregions, and within each of these three subregions, we have different structural components of the brain emerging from each of the subdivisions. So let's look at what the prosencephalon, the mesencephalon, and also the robencephalon. Let's see what each of these subdivisions developed to become. The forebrain is the most superior part of the brain vesicle. It is the largest part, and it is made up of two subdivisions. So eventually, two subregions will finally develop from the prosencephalon. We have the telencephalon and the diencephalon. The telencephalon becomes the cerebrum hemisphere, while the diencephalon becomes the thalamus, the hypothalamus, the subthalamus, and also the epithalamus. All these structures are located below the cerebrum hemisphere. This is the prosencephalon. This is the most superior part of the primary brain vesicle. And as development proceeds, they become the cerebrum hemisphere, and also the structures that are located below it. So for the cerebrum hemisphere, we have two hemispheres, one on the right and one on the left, and they are joined at the middle by the longitudinal feature. So this is like one side of the cerebrum hemisphere. And what the cerebrum hemisphere controls are the perception of sensory impulses. Also, motor impulses are also perceived within the cerebral cortex. We also have the perception of auditory stimuli, visual stimuli around the occipital region. Then we have the olfactory sensation and taste sensation also being perceived within the cerebrum hemisphere. The second region of the prosencephalon is the diencephalon. There are structures that are located below the cerebrum hemisphere, and this includes the thalamus. The thalamus is a relay station. It's like a bulb that is seen below the cerebrum hemisphere. If we look at some of the tracts that we have discussed on our channel, we've said that the thalamus are like relay station where those pathways intercept their neurons before they finally terminate on the cerebral cortex. Then we have the hypothalamus. The hypothalamus is just below the thalamus from the name, then it is above the pituitary gland. What the hypothalamus control is heartbeat. It also helps to maintain body's homeostatic condition. And it has a tubular connection with the pituitary gland, thereby helping to control the secretion of the pituitary gland. And the next region is the midbrain. The midbrain is like a conduit that is located between the forebrain and the hindbrain. This is the forebrain, as we've discussed in our previous slide. And this is the hindbrain, which is located more distally. So it's like a connection stalk between the upper part of the brain and the lower part of the brain. It's actually the most superior part of the brain stem. This we would see during the course of this lecture. By the time we discuss the brain stem, we would actually see that the midbrain is the most superior part of the brain stem. So during the development of form, we have the mesencephalon, which is the middle primary brain vesicle. So this is where it is located between the prosencephalon and the robencephalon. This structure, as development proceeds, will become the midbrain. And this is the midbrain. Then we have the next structure, the hindbrain. The hindbrain is made up of two subunits. We have the metencephalon and the myelencephalon. The metencephalon becomes the pons and the cerebellum, while the myelencephalon becomes the medulla oblongata. So during the development of form, we have the robencephalon, which is the most distal part of the primary brain vesicle. There's already a subdivision mark created in the robencephalon. So as development proceeds, they finally become the pons, the medulla, and also the cerebellum. The upper part, which is referred to as the metencephalon, becomes the pons and the cerebellum behind, while the inferior part, which is the myelencephalon, becomes the medulla oblongata. And of course, inferior to the medulla oblongata, we have the spinal cord. The cerebellum, which is part of the hindbrain, is known for control of movement and balancing. And let's look at the brain stem. It's like holding a flower by its stem. The brain stem is made up of three parts. We have the midbrain, we have the pons, then we have the medulla. So this is like holding a flower by the stem, whereby you have the upper part that can be referred to as the cerebral hemisphere. And of course, we've said that the midbrain forms the most superior part of the brain stem. The entire structure here forms the brain stem, while the most superior part is the midbrain. So thanks for watching.